Hello, I'm Steve Head, Chancellor of Lone Star College. I would like to welcome you to the 2021 Lone Star College Virtual Graduation Ceremony. This past year has presented you with unprecedented challenges. Despite COVID-19, the winter storm, and the general disruptions in your life, you've been able to remain focused and accomplish something that will change your life. On behalf of all of us at Lone Star College, congratulations. Success is about hard work, discipline, and perseverance. Whether you're entering the workforce, continuing your education, or joining the armed forces, you've proven to yourself that you can be successful under the most stressful circumstances. I would also like to recognize the extraordinary work of our faculty, staff, and administration to ensure that you had the tools and the resources you needed to earn your diploma to prepare you for the next step in your journey. Thanks to them, Lone Star College is recognized as one of the premier community colleges in our country. Please take the time to thank all those people in your life, your family, the extended family, and friends who supported you along the way and are proud to celebrate with you today. Finally, as we look forward toward the future, I hope you will remember what you were able to accomplish during your time at Lone Star College and take what you have learned to help make the world a better place for all of us. Thank you.
Good morning, graduates, parents, family members, friends, trustees, administrators, faculty, and staff. I'm Mario K. Castillo. I'm the interim college president at Lone Star College Kingwood. And I'm honored to welcome you today to our 47th annual commencement exercises. As you can imagine, this is not the type of event we had in mind to honor your achievements and earning your degrees during the pandemic. We realize it's played havoc on the educational system all over the world, your personal and professional lives, and we wish we could all be together today. Nevertheless, we would be remiss if we didn't have an event to congratulate each of you for your hard work and perseverance in your educational journey at Lone Star College Kingwood and Lone Star College in general. I'm certain many of you may have had trepidation and been nervous about continuing your coursework, especially in the wake of COVID-19. It was natural to feel sad, stressed, and uncertain about what was to come. I can tell you that in all honesty, you are not alone. As the system's chief operating officer and general counsel, before also assuming the presidency in September, I learned firsthand how the pandemic disrupted the lives of students, faculty, and administrators across the system. I worked with dedicated personnel who worked diligently to make our facilities safe for our students and staff. From implementing protocols following the CDC guidelines to ensuring we had ample supplies to make our facilities as environmentally safe as possible. It truly was a team effort to safeguard our college system. Soon after arriving at Lone Star College Kingwood in September, these efforts were meticulously followed because I wanted to make certain that everyone knew that safety was our number one priority, and it still is. That's why we're doing it this way. Thank you to all of you for following our safety protocols and for doing your part during these challenging times. It has not been easy, but I hope that today you know it has been worth it. Today, as we take part in this virtual event, faculty and staff members join me in celebrating your achievements and wish you continued success. Indeed, we're privileged to share this day with you. I speak to many staff and administrators and faculty in particular that this is their favorite day of the year. This is why we're here. Today we see the fruits of what we do 364 other days of the year to help you be successful. We see your parents hugging you. We see you hugging your spouses. We see your proud children as they look at you with pride, knowing that their parents did something that hopefully one day they will do too. And so I thought about a variety of things I could speak to you about. But before I get into those, I think context is really important. And so when I say some things, I think if you know a little bit about my background, you'll understand where I'm coming from. I'm a first-generation American. My parents were both born in Mexico. I'm the proud eldest son of two blue-collar immigrants, one with a high school education and the other one with a more modest only middle school one. I could tell you that my first job was vacuuming the houses of the people that hired my mother to clean their homes I could also tell you how I left home when I was still in high school and finished high school working full time. And somehow I still managed to go to the University of Texas at Austin and be the first in my family to graduate from college, like many of you. There are many of you in the audience that you are the first person in your family to graduate from college, and we share that in common. How I then went on to Indiana law, worked in the federal judiciary as a briefing attorney for federal judge. How the day after graduating from law school at 25, my little sister came to live with me because I had to step up to the plate as the eldest and help my family raise my sister. I went into private practice and made partner. I then became the general counsel of the largest higher education institution in Texas at 32. But today isn't about me. I just wanted to share some facts with you so that as we work together to survive my speech, you understand some of the points where I'm coming from. And so as you read my bio, which was shared as part of the program, or which you can Google, the bio only speaks of all of my successes. It doesn't talk about my failures. And I think to students, we often do them a disservice by not talking about our failures. My bio doesn't talk about the jobs I didn't get, the interviews that went with no callbacks, the promotions I didn't get, the times where I got up in the morning and didn't feel like going to work, where I had difficult supervisors. It doesn't talk about any of those things. And we just don't talk about those things. But there really is one thing that we all share in common. We all want the next generation, particularly our children, to do better and to have it easier than we did. And there's really only one way, going back to the things that I told you, my parents taught me, and my dad, again, worked in a factory, and my mom cleaned houses. And my mom, when I used to go with her to clean houses, she would say, in Spanish, of course, but I'll translate for y'all, there's only one way to get ahead in this country, and that's to work hard, and that is to put in the time. There's no other way around this. Anyone who's telling you that there's shortcuts, that you can get rich quickly, is probably trying to sell you something, or lying, or both. Malcolm Gladwell wrote a book several years ago about 10 qualities of successful people called outliers. Some qualities were inherent, others were not. One of the non-inherent qualities was that successful people did the task at which they excelled just more than anybody else. He posited that if you did a task at least 10,000 hours, you could be successful. And to put that in perspective, because I am a labor and employment attorney, a full-time job is 2080. Hours of work a year. So if you think about it, if you're working a full-time job, it's going to take you about 5 years to become an expert at that job. And that's 10,000 hours of focused, committed, hard work time. Hard work time doesn't include Snap. It doesn't include doing things for the gram or Facebook for those of us that are older. Hard work means just what it sounds like. You're working hard to succeed. And not working hard or being unprepared is unworthy of any profession, whether you are cleaning toilets, as my mother did, or running a college, as I'm blessed to do. It is unworthy of the person for whom you are working. It is unworthy of you. It is unworthy of the people that you're leading. It is unworthy of the many people who invested in you along the way. One of the things that I always think about when I'm considering being lazy, sleeping in, or cutting a corner is the awesome sacrifice my parents made coming to this country so I could have better opportunities in life. And then I don't cut that corner. Think about all the professors that stay late to help you, the folks in student services that their shift ended, but they stayed to help you. We must ourselves attempt greatness, because when we are given opportunities or opportunities are provided to us, we should honor those gifts by maximizing those opportunities to the best of our abilities. Be humble to the point of over-preparing. There's no such thing as ever being over-prepared. You can't know too much. In many professions, no day is ever the same. Some of you are moving on to a four-year institution. Some of you are going into the workforce. Whether you are over-prepared for an exam at your four-year university or your graduate program, or your doctoral program, or whether you're going into the workforce because you've earned a certificate your GED, or something to that effect. There's no real 2 days that are the same, so you have to be prepared. If you fail because you did not work hard and were unprepared, you should not be shocked or disappointed. You made that choice. You achieved what you earned. And there's only one person that's responsible, you. And that really brings me to the main message of my, hopefully, short speech here. There are many things in life that we cannot control. I cannot control, just like you, who my parents were. I cannot control the circumstances in which I was born. I cannot control the resources that were available to me and my family growing up. But there are 3 things that you can control, and I wanted to share those 3 things with you. Number one, you can always control your effort. I can tell you that I have done many things in my life, but there have been, when I have failed at something, it is rare when I did not try my very best. And sometimes your very best, and this is one of the most humbling things I learned in law school, is not going to be good enough. And that is when we lean on our family and our friends and our support structures. Because remember, one of the key things, your family loved you before you had 3 stripes, like someone with a doctorate. Your family loved you before you had a master's degree. Your family loved you before you had a bachelor's degree. Your family loved you before you had an associate's degree or a certificate or even your GED. Your family loved you way before you were the chief operating officer or the interim college president, before you were the general counsel, and your family will love you after all those things are gone. And so make sure that you make time for your family. But your effort should always be maximized. That is one thing you can control. Again, there's no such thing as being overprepared. Number 2, your attitude. Even if you try your very hardest, again, sometimes that's not going to be good enough. There are things outside of our control, like the pandemic. The pandemic has forced all of us to do things in a way that we wouldn't like to do. I would like to be able to take off my mask, for example, and speak to you so that you could see my full face. I would like to give this speech to an auditorium full of smiling and happy students with their parents out in the stands, seeing you afterwards looking for your parents handing you gifts, hugs, and the pictures in the parking lots. But we don't always get what we want. And so I'm trying to follow the advice that I'm giving you and making the best of this situation. Attitude is so important, graduates. Trust me. And let me tell you something. It is incredibly important. It is incredibly important that you follow this piece of advice because it has helped me a great deal. It is nice to be important. It is. It's nice to have titles. It's nice. But it is more important to be nice. And remember that there are people throughout the hierarchy that can teach you things. Many of the lessons that I'm sharing with you, I didn't learn in a doctorate program. I didn't learn in law school. I learned from a factory worker and a lady that cleans houses. I learned from custodians. I learned from groundskeepers. I learned from faculty members. I learned from staff. And I'm always willing to learn because there's always going to be someone willing to teach you if you're always willing to learn. And the last part of it is a little bit more practical advice. Your expenses. You can control your expenses. Many times when I talk to students, particularly students that want to be lawyers, they always talk about the money they want to make, about the BMWs and the Mercedes-Benz that they want to drive, about the houses and the bedrooms and all of that. And that's the revenue side of the balance sheet. What we don't talk about enough are the expenses. So let me just tell you, because I am a dad, and I went camping with my daughter a few weeks ago, and my daughter and I were sitting around a campfire, and she was telling me, she's 6 years old, by the way, she was telling me scary stories, or at least stories she thought were scary. And then she asked me what I thought was a scary story, and she told me several times, "Dad, tell me a scary story." And so finally I said, "Let me tell you what a scary story is, Amelia. Not being able to pay your bills is scary. And my wife this very morning teased me about what a dad moment that was, and that was such a dad thing to say. And you know, I do have two kids, so guilty as charged. But really, I can tell you that I grew up in a household where, notwithstanding how hard my parents worked, it was difficult to make ends meet, like many of you. And I promised myself that if I ever, quote, made it, my expenses would always be much more modest than my income. And so that's advice that I have for you. Always keep track and be meticulous about your expenses. Yes, again, it's important to maximize your earning potential, but I can tell you that I've met people that made $40,000 that had more money in the bank than people who make $1 million because they're not keeping track of their expenses. And so the last bit of practical advice that I want to leave you with is something I wish someone would have told me. As a first-generation American, first-generation college student, I had to take out a good amount of loans. By the time I graduated from law school, I owed pretty much more than I owed for my house. And so I want to share with you something that you can use practically starting tomorrow. And something that most people will not tell you, but I will. Every day that you owe student loans, daily accrual interest is accumulating daily. So instead of paying once a month the monthly payment that the banks and other lenders want you to pay, you can actually pay every day. If you call your bank, you can break up that 30-day payment into 30 payments each day. And so little by little, you start paying that interest, you will see the principal go down faster than if you are just paying the 30-day note. So there you go. And if you want to Google it, if you're like already checked out and you're like, I can't wait for this guy to finish so that Javier can get up here, our student speaker, let me just leave you with one phrase. Google micro transactions for paying student loans. In closing, again, there are three things that you can control: your effort, your attitude, and your expenses. I hope that all of you are as proud of us as we are of you. I know that your parents are very proud. If you have children like I do, you know, they tend to be our biggest fans. And on behalf of the chancellor, the board of trustees, all of the administrators at System Office, all of the administrators, faculty and staff here at Lone Star College, congratulations and Godspeed.
Congratulations, class of 2021. It's fantastic to have you here. My name is Xavier Lopez, and if no one has told you yet, if you're watching this, you deserve to be here. Enjoy this moment. If you're someone who's been fortunate enough to get here on a straight road, waiting to hop onto the next bus, stopping at a four-year university, best of luck. If you're the veteran returning home to finish up school, or the mom with two jobs, the road you took here might look a little anything but like a straight line. I wish you the best as well. Nonetheless, I think we can all agree that if you've ever driven to this campus, you'd know that whichever road you're on, it wouldn't be a road without a couple bumps, pauses, or well, by the time you get here, the whole thing might just be the Bikini Bottom, or just Anna and Elsa's personal playground. Results may vary. When I first stepped foot on this campus, I had no clue what to expect. In complete honesty, it was a last-ditch effort to save money, and mind you, I wasn't completely fond of that idea. High school had conditioned me to the concept that Lone Star was a place for those people that couldn't make it to prominent, expensive colleges. From what I was told by my high school peers, community college was a last resort for people that just had no choice. I had all this in mind before dropping my place at a big university. In the summer of 2019, I felt dumb. I felt out of place. I felt lost. There's a lot to consider about a topic when you haven't precisely experienced what you're thinking about. It's almost like explaining a color without saying the name of the color, or putting together a puzzle with just one too many missing pieces. That's how the start of college felt. Rather, the moment right before I entered my first class. I'm sure most of us have experienced that feeling in one way or another. That gut feeling, that anxious, uncomfortable, nervous feeling of uncertainty. I was never one to take risk, but Lone Star quickly proved itself to be one of the best bets I have ever made with myself. It was not long until the campus and its entire community had accepted me with open arms, despite my falsified, preconceived notions. I'd never been more wrong about anything in my entire life. The first lesson that this school taught me was that it is okay to be wrong. The other lesson was that if something is a learning experience, it is almost always also a risk. No one seeks out to learn something new because they're entirely confident or comfortable with the subject that they're trying to learn about, such as life. There is no growth without a certain level of discomfort. Soon after my first few weeks, I felt the need to sign up for anything I possibly could. Of course, this was when the campus was more open, so all this was easier at the time, but I became involved with a few clubs, and I met some very impactful people to help me along the way. People who would challenge my ideas, support my ambitions, and teach me valuable lessons, none of which, the least, was that change is okay. In fact, it's sometimes good, even if it may not feel that way at the moment. In fall 2019, I felt like I was heading in the right direction, boosted by the morale of my peers and the opportunities that seemed to fall right into place. I was not lost anymore. I did not feel dumb. And I felt as if I had found my place, finally, in this big, scary world. That change only persisted. Speaking of change, it would be ridiculous of me to not point out the obvious. So let's take a moment to realize, if you haven't already, you're probably at home right now, eating Cinnamon Toast Crunch in your pajamas, thinking to yourself, how does this guy know exactly what I'm doing right now? There's gotta be one of you. And I'm jealous of whoever you are. But yes, this is virtual. And you're probably sick of that word. So am I. Other phrases you may also be sick of include, but are not limited to, my mic isn't working, or can you hear me, or sorry, I forgot to mute myself, or your mic cut out, could you please repeat that, and we all can't forget, please turn on your webcams. This class has been through snowstorms, pandemics, quarantines, and floods. And on top of all that, each of us has an entire list of personal obstacles and events that made this year just that much more difficult. And after all that, you still manage to be here, listening to some guy that you probably don't even know talk for just a little bit too long. Congratulations, class of 2021. You have surpassed change. You have experienced discomfort, and by continuing your education through times like these, you have taken a huge risk, and you have won. Consider this year an opportunity for growth, if not anything else. As we proceed with closing this chapter in our lives, continue to make large strides until you are not simply the person you had merely hoped to become, but the person that you want to be, and more. You may not be able to control everything around the world and everything in it, but the decisions you make today and after today and forever after that will ultimately become your legacy. Whatever road you choose to take after your stop here at Lone Star will undoubtedly be full of detours and accidents and bumps and stops and pauses and a few unknown destinations. Uncertainty is often and it is sure to be so. If it is bound to our lives, then we ought to learn to love this something, even if we may not be sure of what is to come of it. To an extent, we do have power over these unpredictabilities and how we choose to approach the unknown. Stay focused, stay true to yourself, stay fixated on your goals, and carve your legacy into the world so apparently that none of us could possibly ignore it. You have made it this far. As you continue into the unknown, do so with a smile. Keep moving forward. Again, congratulations, class of 2021. Thank you.
Hello, my name is David Beatty, Vice President of Instruction. Lone Star College Kingwood has three early college high schools, so today we are pleased to have 188 of these students from Infinity, Quest, and Splendora early college high schools. Many of these students are receiving their associate's degree before they receive their high school diplomas. During these past 8 years, we have had 1,003 early college high school graduates receive a college degree. The success of these programs is a tribute to not only the capabilities of the students, but also those behind the scenes leading the efforts at these three ISDs. I would like to recognize the administrators from these ISDs who partner with us in making these programs possible for these students and changing their lives. From Humble ISD, Superintendent Dr. Elizabeth Fagan, Quest Early College High School Principal Ms. Michelle Scott, Assistant Principal Ms. Kimberly Esparza, Counselor Ms. Nicole Ashby, and Counselor Mr. Saxon Batungbakal. From New Caney ISD, Superintendent Mr. Matt Calvert, Infinity Early College High School Principal Ms. Trish Beal, Assistant Principal Ms. Erica Sykes, Counselor Ms. Rhonda Souter. From Splendora ISD, Superintendent Dr. Jeff Burke, Assistant Superintendent Dr. Tammy Gregerson, Assistant Superintendent Dr. Glenn Barnes, Director of Secondary Curriculum and Instruction, Dr. Susan Hoisington, Splendora High School Principal, Ms. Diana Archer, Counselor, Ms. Ann Lugie, Counselor, Ms. Amy Nichols, Counselor, Ms. Jennifer Tamayo, and Counselor, Ms. Dawn White. Thank you all for your help and support.
Greetings to all of you. As a member of the Board of Trustees of the Lone Star College System, I now confer upon each of you the certificate of completion of the General Education Development Program, the requirements and exam for which you have completed, with all of the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Traditionally, now is the time to turn your tassels as a symbol of the completion of our degree. If you are able to, please feel free to join me and turn your tassels from right to left. Congratulations, graduates of Lone Star College Kingwood Class of 2021.
Graduates, congratulations to the Class of 2021. It's an honor and a privilege to address you here today. Graduates, I would like to share with you the three P's that have served me well throughout my career. The first, know your purpose. Some of you will enter the workforce and others will continue your education with one of our university partners. Whatever journey you may take, inspire to make a difference in the lives of others and your community. Take the time to discover your passion and understand why you are here. Purpose is different from finding a job because it defines who you are and who you will become. It encourages you to ask those tough questions and drives you to learn more about your craft, ensuring you are competent in your profession. It may not be easy, but well worth the journey. The second P, protect your peace, because it impacts your mental and your physical health. We have experienced a worldwide pandemic, causing the United States to declare a public health emergency. Thousands of people would succumb to the COVID-19 disease. While we waited for scientists to share information on how COVID was transmitted and if we'd get a possible vaccine, we went from a community of interacting with family and friends to social distancing, from attending classes on campus to meeting virtually. Social injustice captured our nation, which sparked the Black Lives Matter movement in states around the country. This movement forced us to deepen our knowledge around the effects of racism and police reform. In addition to many of us, have experienced hardships such as food insecurities, a loss of income, or the loss of a loved one. However, through it all, you have accomplished your dream of graduating. When you are met with difficult situations, I encourage you to seek support from experienced and qualified individuals that can help you manage stress as well as continue to navigate through our challenges together. The final P, pay it forward. I encourage you to use your education to help others. You have a unique skill set, perseverance, dedication, and I believe you will agree, we are all on our way to becoming digital citizens. You have a spirit of fight, and there is much work to be done in our community. As an educator, I'm a firm believer in helping others and empowering students to change the future. Graduates, I'm sure you have a list of family, friends, faculty, staff, and our administrators that you would like an award to award a virtual certificate of appreciation for their support and sacrifice during your course of study. Now it's your turn to pay it forward. Use your education to create opportunities for others to do the same. In closing, as you discover your purpose, protect your peace, and pay it forward, this is an opportunity for you to deepen your knowledge and become a catalyst of change. Graduation is an important milestone in your life. Congratulations, and we look forward to the great work you will do in the future. Thank you.